gonna thank your mother for a butt like that. You're a shotgun, hey!
Alright, what's up guys, I'm back with another video. Now the update just dropped for Marvel Legacy, and I kind of wanted to go into X-23. Now, like the Ultimates, she's only acquirable through the lab processor. Now there is event missions, however, going on to get extra bios for her and things like that, but that's going to eventually go away and we're going to have to rely just on the processor. With that being said, in this video, I'm not going to be giving any of my thoughts on the actual update. I will do that in a video that will come this weekend. But nevertheless, what I want to do in this video is I want to go through the lab processor. I have almost 500,000 antimatter to use, and I want to see exactly how many bios I get. So I'm going to run the next clip of me opening a ton of them, and then I'm going to come back and break it down a little bit for you guys.
Every day that I wake up, I wake up in a nightmare. Every day that I wake up, I can never see quite clear. When I look at my surroundings, and everybody still doubts me, I wanna live to hear a crowd sing all my lyrics so loudly. I miss a time when we would all get together. I guess it's fine, but I really wish that we were better. Real talk, sipping drinks without all the pressure. Now everybody needs to think about posting whatever. When people ask how I'm doing, I've never been better. That's really not a conversation I'm willing to enter. How come we all continue forcing out all of this pressure? I'm just sick of these opinions and all of these lectures.
I need my space now so I can feel nothing. I live this nightmare so I can be something. Yeah. I do what
rich, I'm scared of being poor. I'm scared of being lonely, but I'm scared of being bored. Sometimes I get really angry, and I don't know why. Sometimes I really do hate me. Can't even pick my own side. What is even going on? Why the hell do I even write songs?
Alright, so there I went through 465,000 antimatter collecting biometrics from the lab processor. And now, after doing some
quick maths,
I'm going to break down the results a little bit. So 465,000 antimatter equals out to 155 biometrics in total that I received, or in this case, X genes. And out of those 155 X genes, I got a total of 41 X23 genes, which equals out to roughly 27% X23 genes that I received. Now, if we look at the characters eligible to be pulled from this chest, you can see that there's actually only 5 characters able to be pulled, so my odds should be roughly around 20% of the time I get X23 genes. However, out of those 41 bios that I got, 3 of my pulls were a jackpot, which means that I got 2 genes instead of 1. Now if we take out the jackpot rolls and count them solely as one biometric, equaling out the 38 times that I pulled her from this chest, that equates to roughly 25% of the time I pulled X23 genes, which is still over what my odds should be. However, we could just count that to luck. It's not a big difference. It's a 5% difference. We could equate that to luck. Maybe luck was on my side a little bit here. So I did get more than what I should have. However, I'm not going to complain. I'd rather the extra 5% biometrics, as she is pretty hard to acquire. So we know that 25% of the time I pulled X23 genes, and 7% of the time out of those pulls, I got a jackpot, which in turn cost me 465,000 antimatter, 4,650 gear up kits, 1,550 Mkron shards, as well as gave me a sore thumb. However, that much antimatter doesn't just fall into your lap. If once again I do some more
quick maths,
that means that if you were to log in every couple of hours for an entire day straight and do it consecutively every day, it would take roughly 6.5 days for me to get the amount of antimatter that I had, which means it would take you roughly 6.5 days to get 41 X23 biometrics. But it doesn't take 41 biometrics to max a character. It actually takes 630 just to bring them to 6 stars, and then it takes approximately another 400 just for their gears, and another 150 to bring them to tier 2 the old-fashioned way. In order to get 630 biometrics from the processor, I would have to log in every day, like I said, get as much antimatter as I can. And even at that point, I would have to be pulling her biometrics for 100 days straight in order for me just to bring her to 6 stars. And then if I wanted to bring her to tier 2, it would take me another 87 days, totaling for 187 days, just to bring one character to tier 2. That is 6.5 months. Now I find that's incredibly ridiculous. There's no way anybody can get this character to tier 2 without shelling out money. Now like I mentioned earlier, we do have the event going on, which does make it easier. However, just going based off the processor, that is an insane amount of time. And I think, you know, I honestly don't have a problem with Netmarble releasing certain characters like the Ultimates and X-23 through solely the lab processor. However, I think they need to up the maximum level for the antimatter generator. Maybe bring it to level 20, you know, that way maybe they can put it that at level 20 you get about 5,000 every 30 minutes. That would cut down the time a little bit, making it, you know, 3 times as fast. It would take you 33 days or roughly a little over a month to bring that character to 6 stars, and then it would take around 7 weeks to bring them to tier 2, which in my head is not so bad. But I really think if they're going to be releasing characters solely through the lab processor, they got to do something to allow us to get more antimatter quicker. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it to wrap up this video. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope to see you in the next video, and I'll see you in the next one. That made absolutely no sense. Adios. I've been